It is Heart Health Month, and our stories with MedStar Health continue this morning. I'm here with Dr. Robert Lager to help us understand why just being a man makes you more likely to get heart disease at a younger age. And it sounds a little harsh, but I guess it's just the reality of things, right? Why is that so?
You know, for many years, cardiovascular disease was really thought of as a male problem. We know that's not the case. It's the number one killer for men and women, so I should start by saying that. But there are different ways that men present than women. It's really worth talking about to kind of recognize the differences.
So, obviously biological ways is one, and then obviously our lifestyle is another. Start with the biological. Is this something that we can change, or we just have to accept that being a man puts you in a little different position when it comes to your heart health?
It's definitely true. There are definitely hormonal differences between men and women. Women are producing and exposed to estrogen and progesterone their entire lives, whereas men are really exposed to testosterone. And we didn't know early on whether it was a question of protection for women with estrogen and progesterone or more of an increased risk with testosterone. But it seems that women are protected, at least until menopause, and then they start to catch up. Mm. So a big part of us trying to understand this was sort of seeing how testosterone interacts with risk. And we see that men who develop low testosterone, and most of us start to drop our testosterone levels when we hit 40, start to increase our cardiovascular risk. And it's a reason why men develop heart disease on average about 10 years earlier than women.
Wow. So that's the biological aspect of it. And then we have lifestyle as well. So where do you find the meeting point between the two when it comes to the guys out there?
Well, one of the important things is how we develop and deposit fat. So men deposit fat in their bellies and women more in their hips and their pelvises. This idea of the apple and the pear. So men tend to be apples, women more tend to be pears. And we know that abdominal fat is particularly dangerous fat. It tends to make major changes in our metabolism, increases our blood sugar, increases inflammation, and really can increase the risk of heart disease. So really important attention to diet and exercise can make a big difference, especially for men who carry that fat in their belly.
It's tough though because I can't speak for anybody but myself, but a lot of times you hear that it's like in this year out the other one, right? Because you're just like, I'm kind of already set in my ways, and you don't really want to make that change until you know that you have to make that change.
Yeah.
To stay a step ahead, what are some of the ways that we should do that? Is it really just if we're a little bit bigger in the belly, is it just losing weight, or is it just cutting out certain foods from our diet that'll help us out?
Well, we think the Mediterranean diet still seems to be king when it comes to cardiovascular health, and that means really staying away from processed foods and high-fat foods, fried foods. But really, a lot of it is exercise, and exercise has been shown really to impressively reduce cardiovascular risk. So just getting out there and doing something every day can make a huge difference in terms of your risk of heart attack and stroke.
And I guess when it comes to the exercise for the best cardiovascular health, does it matter how intense that is, or is it really just getting something done?
Something is always better than nothing. I think that's the key point. You don't have to be doing high-intensity interval training, really, to get the benefits. It can be low-level endurance training, some weight training, all kinds of different exercise. But the key thing is something that you'll do, something you'll sustain over time. Not something that'll come and go. You got to keep on it. That's the key point.
What do you look for when somebody comes in? And obviously, the key is we need to get checked, right? And we have to, at some point, have to come see you or a doctor to make sure that we're not getting worse. What are you looking for though when somebody comes in to make sure that everything is working well from a cardiovascular perspective?
Well, I would say one key thing for men, which I think is greatly understated, is the idea about erectile dysfunction. You know, most people think erectile dysfunction is related to low testosterone, but only about 5% of men have low testosterone when they have erectile dysfunction. It's really a marker of vascular disease. So when we see people start to develop erectile dysfunction, it's very common. We should be thinking about screening for vascular disease in particular.
That's interesting, because a lot of folks wouldn't think that. You're right. You would just think automatically it's a testosterone issue.
Exactly.
But you said that's
seldom.
Very low.
Yeah.
One of the other things here in this region, and you can let us know where we fit as far as those across the country, a lot of stressful jobs, a lot of stressful situations. How much does that play a role?
So stress, anxiety, aggression, all these things definitely increase cardiovascular risk. And some of that is actually probably hormonal. Testosterone seems to increase our levels of aggression and anger. There was actually a study that showed that 2 hours after an angry outburst, men are about 5 times more likely to have a heart attack. So
it's not, this is not my line of work. If that happens, right, you get that spike in whatever it is that's pushing that outburst.
Yes.
The heart attack doesn't happen then, it can happen later?
It can happen later. Yeah, it can happen really at any time in the few hours afterwards. So that's particularly important for 49ers fans today, but for everyone in general. It's the kind of thing where heart attacks can occur suddenly, really, at any time without any previous symptoms. In fact, more than half of the heart attacks we see, that's the first symptom of heart disease, is the heart attack, no symptoms prior.
And that's what's important to know. So it all goes back to if you can, work on your diet and exercise.
Where it starts.
Try to stave it off as long as you possibly can. Doctor, thanks for coming in today. I do appreciate it. We'll put the information on the screen there if you want to check out MedStar and what they have to offer. But, check out your local doctor as well. Please go get checked so that you can make sure that you're in the best heart health as possible. Thanks, doctor. Good to see you this morning.
Thank you.